Hello, we're up to episode number 5 of London's Lost Railways. We actually start today here at Staines West. That's what this building now is in Staines, slightly outside of London. But then we go inside London up to West Drayton as we follow the path of the Staines West to West Drayton Railway. The Staines and West Drayton Railway opened in 1884 and was run by GWR, who had to have a separate station, Staines West, as they were not allowed to connect up with the other main Staines station. That railway company had their own separate line running to Windsor. But a connection between the two lines was put in place in the 1940s. Plus later, in the 1980s, a second connection was established, and that was to allow continued access to an oil depot after the line up to West Drayton was closed. And that line up to West Drayton had 5 intermediate stations. Well, some of them barely stations really, but just simple platform halts. And most of them were really infrequently used with very low passenger numbers. So the line eventually closed to passengers in 1965. But there's a surprising amount left to see if you just go looking for it. The line starts at this building here. Nowadays it's been converted into modern offices. But the station's retaining wall still obviously exists, as well as the nice touch of some track with buffers and a sign saying Staines West that's been put in place. But the real fun starts if you walk down Moor Lane and you find the footpath that takes you onto the moors. That's Staines Moor, and then beyond that, Stanwell Moor. You immediately find a bridge which goes over the river and the Windsor line, but is also where there are still old rusty tracks that would have run to West Drayton.
You can come down the bridge to the embankment. You can't go any further because there's a fence, but you can get really close to the old rails. So you've got the old rails of the old Staines West branch and the connection. Then you've got the Raisby River and then the current day lines. The South Western Railway is rolling past going up to Windsor, but you're right here by the old rails with the trees growing up through the metals.
You then have a choice to keep your feet dry and carry on walking down Moor Lane, or do what I did, and that's elect to get your feet soaking wet by walking across the very soggy moor. Follow this path of the electricity pylons and head west to find the trail of the old railway again. And yes, I did have this feeling of bleakness here, but there is also a beauty and tranquility amongst the bleak landscape, which I loved.
So you come to the western side of Staines Moor and you come through this gate for a really cool thing.
As you saw back on Moor Lane when we first entered the moor, there are information boards dotted all over the place. And here, another one pops up, but this time with the most detail I've seen so far about the old railway. The railway, which used to go over this bridge. And after checking out underneath the bridge, the obvious thing to do, of course, is to climb up the steps to where the old alignment used to run.
So I'm on this bridge because the railway had to go high up here to go over the Windsor line before then dropping back down to Staines West. So there's this little tunnel that you can walk under, graffiti. The single track used to go above here. You can hear the planes, we're getting close to the airport.
And the walking path here then is the alignment of the old railway. Now you might see the occasional dog walker around here, but aside from that, it's ghostly quiet. Well, okay, with the rumble of the motorway in the background, which we'll address in a moment. Oh, and there's another information board that gives a nod to the old line. Now the abandoned station to encounter next was first opened as Runnymede Range, but later became renamed to Yeovenry Halt. I didn't think I was going to find any remains of it at all, as online research had shown me that there was nothing left. So I was very, very pleased when I stumbled across some old concrete posts and other things in the location where the station was.
There's also something very definitely railway-esque looking. I think we found it. So I'm walking along a less glamorous part now. The railway was over to my right and then came over this way, over the path and over to here. The noise you can hear is the M25, which obliterated all traces of the railway. And basically, it follows the path up to the junction where we're going next. So thanks, motorway.
So you negotiate junction 14 of the M25 and there's no remains at all of Poyle Halt, but it would have been in this location here. And the next section is then, let's just say, extremely industrial. And an industrial park has now obliterated the location of Poyle Estate Hort. There is nothing to see here, so keep walking. And keep walking until you excitingly find this old bridge where the railway would have crossed a river.
And this is the Poyle Channel. Recording this now quickly before a plane landing at Terminal 5 goes directly overhead. It's a bit noisy if you stand here too long, but the railway has come from along there and it comes out just down there onto our final destination for today, and that's Bath Road.
And we've come to the point where we can go no further, where the rails are still in use. If we look at our original map, there's a section here in red that is still in use as a freight line that heads up to West Drayton. This location, though, would have been Colnbrook Station, and there is still a station house. Or is that a station cottage? It's still here as a private residence, although the most brilliant thing must be the signs and lights that are no longer in use for a level crossing that is no longer here.
And that brings us to the end of this episode, but that freight line there actually goes up to West Drayton, which is where we'll pick up lost railways again, with another old railway there that takes us to Uxbridge in the next episode. If you want to see that, press subscribe and check out the whole playlist. Thanks for watching.